and welcome to this month's Meals Meets. I'm joined in Studio 2 here at Phoenix by the lovely Rosie Webb.
Hello.
Hello, Rosie.
Good afternoon, Nikki.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Thanks
good.
For having me here.
No problem. Thank you for coming in. I do believe this isn't your first time here at Phoenix, is it?
It's not, no. I mean, last year I was on
Eat My Brunch.
Yeah, Eat My Brunch with Michelle. Yeah, that was good. That was
and
good
now you're fun. Here, I've nabbed you. You're here for Meals Meets.
Yeah, look at you, all want a bit of me.
Well, you're good and we're going to hear your performance a little bit later. But I always start my Meals Meets interviews with a few would you rather questions.
So okay. Yeah.
It's always a bit of fun. Okay, so would you rather have an overly high-pitched voice or a very low-toned deep voice?
Oh, I think a very low-toned, deep voice because overly high-pitched would get really annoying.
I was thinking that, yeah.
Yeah, it would get a bit annoying.
Give everyone a headache with that, wouldn't you?
Yeah. And with a low voice, I think it's nice and soothing sometimes as well.
Yeah, that's very true. Second one, would you rather fly around the world with your true love or be stuck on a desert island with your favourite celebrity?
Definitely travel the world.
Really?
Yeah, 100%. Because getting stuck on a desert island would be a bit boring.
That's true.
Wouldn't it? So,
but
yeah.
Who's your favourite celebrity? Who would you get stuck on an island with?
Ed Sheeran.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Yeah, he's just a very talented guy. Yeah, you know what I mean? He could play guitar, serenade me.
Oh. But instead, you've chosen to go around the world.
Yeah. Well,
so you don't get all that.
I know. Oh, well. Oh, well. Be good travelling.
It would. And the last would you rather stay at your current age forever or fast forward to 10 years from now?
So in 10 years from now, I would be 29. And that sounds like a lifetime away. I think I'd love to stay 19 because I don't want to be an adult. I don't want to.
I'm 27, so I'm reaching that already. And I'd rather stay your age.
Yeah, it's a bit scary, isn't it, growing up? Yeah, so I prefer to stay 19 forever. Why
cool.
not?
Well, you have got a very musical background. You sort of grew up with a musical education. Tell us a bit about like the Brit School and the Guildhall School that you're at.
Yeah, so I went to Brit School when I was 16 and I did a community arts course. And so through that course, I did loads of performing arts, different forms of performing arts, and took it out into different communities. And so through those 2 years at Brit School, I really was working a lot with other people and I never really got to find my own music style. But then I started Guildhall. And even though I'd been writing loads and loads through Brit School, I got to Guildhall and I was able to really concentrate on my own music and myself. And it's been great. Yeah, it's like music is in my blood, I think. So, yeah.
Nice. And what style would you say your music is that you like to write?
I really like soulful music. I like R&B tracks. I like songs that have a meaning. I like songs that are like uplifting as well, because I feel like there's too many sad songs around. I like that kind of music.
And you said kind of music is in your blood. How old were you when you were like, this is what I want to do, this is my career?
Oh goodness, I think I was as young as like 7 or 6.
Wow.
You know, I was always going up on stage at the caravan holiday parks, you know, when they had the talent shows, and I was always first up on stage. Like, I loved it.
Yeah.
So I think I've just always enjoyed it. I've always been a bit of a diva. So
yeah. I'll say you're a diva.
No, well, just confident.
Anyway.
Yeah.
And obviously, like, you love to sing and songwrite, but what else do you do when you're not doing music?
What else do? So I volunteer at a couple charities. I also work at a community centre as well. So I'm a really like big people person. I like that. I love writing in general, like poetry and spoken word, things like that. So I'm always trying to be creative, even if it's not music or singing.
Yeah. Creative, that's a good word. I'll say that. Very creative person.
Thank you, yeah.
And you've told me that you might have a little EP on its way. Is that true?
Yes, I do. I mean, last year when I went on Eat My Brunch, I was really hoping to bring out an EP towards the end of the year, but I mean, a lot of artists know, once you start writing a song, it's really hard to just put it down and make it final. So you know, we've been working on quite a few songs over the last year, and so hopefully EP will be out by summertime.
Nice.
In time for the summertime track.
That's a very good lead there.
Yeah, isn't it just? I know. Perfect.
I was about to say, the track that you performed for us when you first came in was Summertime, which is it like your debut single in a way?
Yeah, that was like the first track that I released on SoundCloud, first track that I recorded with Key Changes, and yeah, it's just my favourite one. I think that version that I sung today is a like new remastered version. Nice. So it's quite exciting that we're still building up tracks and stuff.
Cool. Well, as you just mentioned, you performed this. Shall we have a listen to it now?
Yes, please. That'd be great.
Cool. Here is Rosie Webb with Summertime.
Thank you.
keychanges.org.uk. Mm-hmm.
In the summer we were younger, yeah. We had nothing on our mind. In the summer we were younger, yeah. When we had endless time. Let's go back in time, babe, and buy another drink. Let's go back in time, babe. Tell me what you think. 'Cause I'm feeling good tonight, and the sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, are you feeling my vibe in the summertime? 'Cause I'm feeling good tonight, and the sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, are you feeling my vibe in the summertime? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. In the summertime. In the summertime. Dreams of seeing you, yeah, yeah, on a beach where the waves are clear and blue. I know there's nothing better than strolling through the sand with you. Honey, step into the water, I know that you want to, yeah. Let's go back in time, babe, and say back in time, baby. Let me change the way you think. 'Cause I'm feeling good tonight. The sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, are you feeling my vibe in the summertime? 'Cause I'm feeling good tonight. And the sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, are you feeling my vibe in the summertime? Yeah. In the summertime. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. In the summer. In the summertime. I'm feeling good tonight, and the sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, are you feeling my vibe in the summertime? 'Cause I'm feeling good tonight, and the sunshine is in my eyes. Yeah, I'm feeling in the summertime. Yeah, in the summertime. Yeah, in the summer.
That's definitely giving me the vibes for summertime.
Thank you.
It's getting me excited for the sun, which we don't have a lot of at the moment.
I know. I mean, it's peaking out there,
yeah,
but
it's getting there.
It's getting there.
So you mentioned before that track that you've done a bit of work with a charity called Key Changes even.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that.
So Key Changes are a music charity that support people with mental health issues through music engagement. So they hold open mics. They have award-winning services where they offer music making and recording sessions to people who struggle with mental health, and they go to Highgate Mental Health Hospital and do sessions there, and they're just a really amazing charity that really care about people who are struggling and want to make them feel better.
Definitely.
Really.
And
great.
How did you get involved in it?
So when I recorded my first track, Summertime, I actually went through that through like a music production program, and that's where I met Key Changes, because it's on the third floor of my work building in the community center, so it's all like kind of, you know, close together. And I just remember going up there, and it was a lot of younger people who were around me, because I was 18 at the time, and everyone else was like 14 and 15, still kind of like settling their feet. So I just met with Johan, one of the producers at Key Changes, and we started writing Summertime together. We were really feeling each other's vibes, and yeah, we just worked really well. So they just invited me back again and again and again, and now they give me a studio session once a week in exchange for volunteering there, which is great.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Thank you.
Because I did want to mention Key Changes and work they do, because obviously at the moment, like, mental health is such a big topic.
Yeah, definitely.
So if there's people watching and they're kind of struggling a little bit with mental issues, how can music help them?
Oh, in so many different ways, whether it's writing your own music, listening to music, whether it's just feeling how you're feeling through music. I think it's such a, there's so many ways that music can help someone feel better, or, you know, take their mind off of things. Like, it's definitely helped me throughout the years, and through working with Key Changes, seeing the people that struggle with those issues and seeing them, you know, come into the studio or perform on stage at open mics, they are so free and so happy to be there, that that is so important for them. And I think it's important for anyone who struggles with mental health, or even just being sad and lonely sometimes. Like, music is such a joyous thing that really brings people together.
It's good that it can bring so much positivity.
100%. Cool. Yeah, like, Key Changes really push that as well. Like, they have such a positive message, and they are such an important charity that I, you know, I love to work with. And I just actually recently raised £100 for them an event that I held a couple months ago.
Tell us about that event, because that is something on my questions that I wanted to ask.
So for our project at school, we had to, well, individually, we had to create our own event for our module. And so I held an event called Young Creatives, which was a night of free performances from different young artists, including spoken word, a beatboxer, singers, musicians. And it was a free night, and it was on for an hour and a half, and we managed to raise £100 for Key Changes, and we was able to support loads of young artists as well in the process. And it was really successful, and I really hope to hold another one again soon.
Well done. Yeah, that sounds really good.
Thank you.
Sad I missed out on that night. Sounds really good.
Thank you.
Is there
going to
be another one?
Yeah, hopefully in the summer.
Nice.
Yeah,
that'd be good. And then you can sing Summertime, and it'll come together.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Cool. Well, if people want to keep up to date with your music and Key Changes, how can they do that via social media? What have you got?
So Key Changes is on Twitter and Facebook, just Key Changes. And their website is keychanges.org.uk. My SoundCloud is Rosie Webb, and that's where two of my tracks are at the moment. Working on my EP, so that's coming, that's being put together, and hopefully that'll be debuted on SoundCloud very soon.
Cool, exciting times.
Thank you.
Sounds good. Looking
forward
to your EP. But before you leave the studio today, if you're a regular viewer of Meals Meets, you will know I always get my guests to try a world record, and you're going to try one today.
Okay.
What have you chosen? Tell them.
I have chosen to see how many toilet rolls I can stack in 30 seconds. And the world record is held by a woman. Is it a woman or a man? I'm not sure.
They're Italian.
Italian person in 2013. And the record was, it 28 that I have to beat?
Yeah. So we're going to get set up for that and then see how Rosie does.
Amazing. Thanks. Let's go.
So I've had to put the camera somewhere I've never thought I'd put it in the studio. It is a really weird angle, but the only way we can get the toilet rolls in the camera is to do it like this. So, Rosie, you ready for this?
Yes, I am 100% ready. I've watched a lot of videos of people doing this. I feel like I've got enough brain power to do it.
Cool. All right, then. So I'm going to read you the rules. So Rosie is attempting the world record of the tallest toilet paper tower in 30 seconds. The amount to beat is 28 rolls. So we have the toilet roll set up here, as we can see. Okay, the rules. Standard toilet roll must be used, which we've got. You can only stack one roll at a time. And, this is the tough bit, the tower must stay standing for an extra 10 more seconds after the 30-second stack is over.
Okay, sounds undoable, but let's try it.
It's a bit of fun. We'll see. Okay, so we have a timer here. Could you just unlock your phone so we can get the timer up? We've got 30 seconds to do this in. Are you ready? Stopwatch. There you go. Ready? In 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, so we have one, we have two. We're going well already. You're doing one per second, so this is pretty good actually. If you carry on with this, you can do 30. That's 10 seconds gone. Oh, it's going. You can do it again, start again. You got halfway through. So We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop. Okay, so I didn't actually see how many you got there, but obviously didn't get the world record because it fell. How are you feeling?
Oh, it was a very long journey, but it was quite, you know, it was quite inspiring to be here anyway, so it's all right. Toilet rolls, hey. What are you going to do with them?
Now we have plenty for the studio, so yeah. Phoenix presenters, here's your loo rolls. Well, Rosie, thank you very much for being a guest on Meals Meets. Just to remind everyone how they can follow you on social media.
Well, my Instagram is Autumn Leaves. It's spelled AXTUMNLEAVES. And my SoundCloud is just Rosie Webb.
Cool. Thank you very much. So check Rosie out. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next month.